you all are fine, taking good care of yourself. Yes, please be very safe. You know, right? We are already suffering with COVID-19 pandemic. Yes, please do take care of yourself. Okay. I am Nahida. I'll be teaching you social studies for this year 2020-21. Okay? Children, as we all are still fighting with COVID-19, to keep you safe, we are making your home a safe space to learn. Okay? To prevent from illness and infection from bacteria, keep yourself hygienic by washing your hands, drink a lot of water, cover your mouth especially while coughing and sneezing, keep your nails trim and cut clean, and maintain social distancing. Avoid fast food, rather eat healthy food. Children, being home all day and not being able to come to school, it makes difficult to keep up a daily routine. I suggest you write a list of things you can do or develop, which automatically motivates you. Okay? The activities you can add in your daily routine are meditation, exercise, studying, learn a new hobby. Okay? Meditation, what does it do? It calms your mind. Exercise keeps you active. Studying gives you knowledge. Learn a new hobby. It's fun to do it. Okay? Children, the life lesson that we learn from a lockdown is family bonding. What did we learn? Family bonding. That is, the family is which eats together, prays together, and stays together. Yes. Student, now by now you must have received your new books, right? Yes. I want you to maintain 200 pages for classwork and 100 pages book for homework. Okay, I'll be giving you a regular assignments and I want you to do it on time. Okay? To make you understand more better way, I have a small story which tells you about what is history. Okay? Do you all know? But still, I'll tell you a small story which gives you a complete details how, when, and how we got to know what is history. Okay? History is a story of human beings like us who lived in the past. Okay? Now you understood? It's history is the story about human beings who lived in the past. It is an interesting subject. It tells us stories about many people who lived hundreds or even thousands of years ago. How do we know such about the people who lived in the past? How? The answer is that the planet Earth is a home to us and was also a home to them who lived in the past. Okay? People called archaeologists played the game of treasure hunt. Okay? They find evidence or proofs about the past with the help of the clues. Okay? Slowly, they collect enough evidence or treasures to make a real story about the past. Is it interesting now? Yes, now you understood? How can we get the information about the past? Yes? Yeah. Understanding history. How do we know that? The word history comes from the Greek word historia. Greek word, okay? Which means learning or knowing by inquiry. Historians are curious people who study and record the happening of the past. It is not easy, but they make history easy to understand for us by dividing it into ancient, medieval, and modern history. They are able to make their divisions according to the sources and written records found. We study history to know the past. We also study to collect knowledge and information. History helps us to know about the life of the people who lived long, long ago. Historians say that some thousands of years ago, people lived in forests. They were called food gatherers, which means they collected their food. They did not know how to grow their food and were just dependent on things like wild berries, roots and fruits. They hunted animals for their flesh and ate them raw. They did not even wear clothes to begin with and later covered their body with leaves and animal skin. A lot of happenings took place in the lives of early humans. Many things happened by chance. Let us find out about them. Humans learned the art of growing food just by chance. Historians learned through research that probably humans discovered that when a seed fell on a damp ground, it grew into a tree of the same fruit. Everything happened slowly and took a lot of time. Historians say that about 8,000 years ago, humans started growing crops such as wheat and barley. This was the beginning of agriculture. Agriculture changed their lifestyle. They learned to settle down. Next, they domesticated animals and learned to live in groups that later looked like villages. The dog was the first animal to domesticate. Around 4,700 years ago, life changed again as humans made progress. Cities and towns came into being. They faced natural disasters like floods and earthquakes, but braved them all. The study of history helps us. The study of social, political, and administrative setup at different times. Learn and know about the life of the people and how it changed. Compare the present time to the past to calculate our progress. Correct mistakes of past by not repeating them in the present and by taking better decisions for future. Learn that whatever we have achieved in our lives in present is based on the hard work and discoveries of humans in the past. Yes, so I end my small story here. Now by this you must have understood, right? What is history? Why are we learning history? How are we learning history? Yes? Okay. Yes, children. Now we'll start with our first lesson, that's the first theme. Okay? This is the first theme, the story of the past and evidence in history. Okay? Here we'll know what is present, what is past, and what is future. Okay? You learned earlier that time is measured in seconds, minutes, hours, days, weeks, months and years. Okay, this is how you learn. Yes, children, now we know how we measure time. Okay, how to measure time, that is seconds, then comes minutes, then minutes into hours, from hours it counts days, from days weeks, from weeks, months, from months, how many months totally? 12 months, from 12 months it comes to When it is now, at present. Yes, you tell like that, right? So now, it is present. Things happen, even take place in the present. Okay, for example, you are reading a book in the present. Okay, now you are reading a book, right? The books are in your hand. Yes, so it is your present moment. If you write a story of your present, you might say, wow. Okay, the time before the present is called past. Okay, the time present, now is the present. The time before present is called past. This is before. Before, can you see the arrow mark? Yes, this is before present, it is called past. After present, after present, it is called future. Okay, it is called the future. Present is now, before present is past, and after present is future. Okay, now you understood? Yes. Now you understood difference between past, present and future. Events have taken place in the past too. When we learn about the people and events of the past, we understand their story. It is the story of past. Okay? Yes. How do we learn about the past? One way is to read books. There are so many ways in which we can learn about the past. In the next chapter, you will learn something about why we learn about the past, how we learn about the past. Okay? Yes. Yes, children. Now we'll start with our first lesson, the story of the past. Page number 10. Okay, page number 10, the story of the past. Yes, now we'll start reading the lesson. I want you to take a hold a pencil in your hand to underline the hard words. Okay, you remember, right? I want you to underline the hard words. Yes, now we'll start with the lesson. Our first lesson: when you find out these things, you are finding out about the past. When you look at old photograph, underlined photograph of your family, you are looking at the past. So what is the saying? When you have an old photograph in your home of your family, your grandparents, great grandparents, you have an album, right?
You take, huh?
Underline is the game word history. that place, who were the people who lived there, what are the constructions, what are the monuments they made. That is also is called history. In history, we learn about the event that happened in the past to people and to the place. In history, what do we learn? The event. Event, anything like something good also, maybe a war or some festival they celebrated or some function they attended. These all are events, okay, which all had happened in the past. Why the events of the past happened? Why it happened? Because famous people, because of famous people and the lives of ordinary people who lived in the past. Okay? How it happened? By whom it happened? Because of famous people and by ordinary people who lived in the past. Okay? For example, the famous people, whom can you give us? Mahatma Gandhi. Yes? He is famous, right? He is father of our nation. Yes? He fought for our country. Okay? With non-violence and violence. He did with the non-violence way. Okay. When we learn about the past in this way, we are learning history. What are we learning? We are learning history. We are trying to know what has happened in the past. Yes, children. Now next is, why do we learn history? Why do we learn history? Because there are many reasons why we learn history. Let's check what are the reasons to learn history. Learning about the past is interesting. Yes, underline the word interesting. Learning about the past, you sit in here to or listen to your grandparents' stories, right? You ask them, tell us the story. We want to know what happened when you were young. Yes, that is all history. So you are very keen to know what has happened in the past. So it was very interesting. For example, history tells us that earlier there were no internet. So people wrote letters to each other on paper. Now you must have not seen, but ask your parents. They must have written letters to their parents, their friends, their teachers and all. Okay? But earlier there were no internet, no mobiles, no pagers, nothing. So people used to write on paper and send it through post. These were sent through the post office and took several days to reach. And it was not going now how you type a message on WhatsApp and send it and immediately it goes within no seconds. But before people used to write letters, send it through post. It goes to post office, then it has to be delivered to the person whom we send the letter. And it took many days, several days to reach. History helps us to understand. Underline the word understand. History helps us to understand how people of earlier times lived. How people lived earlier times. In the past, how people lived. We'll come to know now. Okay? For example, when we study history, we learn that in earlier times, there were no cars. Okay? No cars. No trains, buses or aeroplanes. No vehicles at all. When people travelled over land, they walked or travelled in vehicles drawn, pulled by animals. So earlier people used to walk for a long distance. They used to walk, otherwise if it is too long, they used to sit on vehicles drawn. That's the animals used to pull. story where we all were